clients. As this evolved, you know, I mean, like being get in shape for women. I mean, literally ask for people to be out of shape, you know, and come in and just to get into shape. Yeah. So it was a lot of weight loss program. I mean, they did cardio. It was a nice functional.
Yeah.
Hitting everything. Like, and it was just women. So it got me to be more my feminine side growing up in the gym and being around men.
You kind of put on a hard outside.
We don't have the cleanest mouth.
How much crap they give you every day. Uh-huh. And it's just like, yeah, you're a bro now, so here.
Yeah, and you have to bust balls to speak their language.
Oh, yeah, or they're just going to be like,
yeah.
She's just a girl.
You're just a girl. Whatever.
I just want to lift with you guys.
Angie, you're taking too long in your warm-up.
All like, right, are you going to grab a bar Taylor yet? Because he does this every damn day. And yet, I catch up to them, and we did a great workout today. Mm-hmm. But it's just like, man, you're going to have a fourth kid. You just wait. Just wait until I'm like, Taylor, are you coming? No, I got to take care of my kid. I'm like, all right. Peace. But actually, speaking of kids, you have given is it all natural with your three boys?
No, I have one naturally. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I have three. So I have an eight who just turned eight, one about to turn six, and I have a 3-year-old. And so they're about 22 months apart.
Okay.
So I was at Get in Shape for Women. It was the first time when I got pregnant, which was the best thing because I could still work out. I could still be really fit and go for walks. That was the best pregnancy I have had. Like no medications, still just eating well, napping when I needed to. Like about at this point, I mean, I had been a personal trainer for now. You just pick up routines, you know, you just what works best for you. I like to work out in the afternoon. I could come home, eat, chill for a bit, and then kind of pick up again when you have to go back in the evening, you know? So it was great being, I think, no kids.
Yeah.
And being of one. So after I had my first one, he was a really, really hard delivery. It was very traumatic. It was like 24 hours of like labor.
Oh.
I almost had to go in the emergency C-section. Yeah. They were like, they had the room all prepped and they looked at me because all of a sudden everybody came in.
Yeah.
Okay. And again, so in shape. I think I walked 5 miles like 2 days before I gave birth. It was like, yes. Okay. Loved it. Felt good. To going in of like, oh my God, because I couldn't get him out and it was just long, to room packed. And I looked at a nurse and finally I looked at her. I go, tell me what the fuck's going on.
Yeah.
And she goes, and she looked at my husband and he was like, and she goes, okay, honey, if you don't get this out within 30 minutes, we already have the room prepped. You have to get this baby out within 30 minutes unless we're going in for emergency C-section.
Is that traumatic just to hear somebody tell you, like, child thought out.
My
like,
husband started tearing up first.
Oh
I looked over because he knew my biggest fear. I'm a personal trainer. I'm in the world of taking care of women post C-sections. Like, trust me, when it comes to rehabbing the abs and everything, love it. Because the core is just so magical. And so when they said that they wanted to, like, cut me open, and obviously, like, I'm all for, you do what you got to do.
Right.
I looked at my husband. He started tearing up. And I look at him. I go, you pull your shit together. And he turned into like this beast coach mode.
Cause he's already a big man.
He's a big
right?
man. Yeah. Like I know most people, I mean, I see him and I'm like, I know he's scary, but like when he gets in that mode, like my
wife needs me right now and I'm going to be there for her.
Oh my God. He was in my face. Like, like screaming.
The biggest
and
coach
like,
ever.
I'm a sailor. Every cuss word is just coming fly. I mean, there's no edit at this point. And we were able to get him out. He was actually like sunny side up. So his like face was up instead of down.
Yeah.
He got meconia. Like, yeah. So he had to go to the NICU. Yeah. It was all traumatic. And like he gets yanked away. You know, I mean, I get him and they all kind of go because they have to take him up to the NICU. And I'm just sitting there and I am drugged the fuck up. Like,
so are you by yourself at this point?
Yeah. I couldn't feel him to push. Yeah. Everyone left. It's just me and the doctor. And like, I couldn't feel anything because I had gotten an epidural.
Yep.
It was part of it, probably why I couldn't feel to push him out properly, but he was up. Like he was trying, it's like putting a shirt on this way, you know, like through your face instead of putting it on the crown of your head to come through.
Okay.
So yeah, there was some trauma physically that I had to, I mean, there was a lot of pain like that I had to deal with afterwards and coming off of, like my leg fell off the table.
Didn't feel that?
I tried to lift it up and I just started bursting out laughing. I'm like, I can't feel. Yeah. It was so bad. Like, and it took me a long time to kind of get that stuff detoxed out of my body. And I use the term detox, meaning your body has to remove something. And that's the term that we kind of use for that. So yeah.
What's up, man?
So I got my little man Noah here. Yeah. And then he was the one I delivered naturally. He was so fast, I almost didn't make it to the hospital. And I quickly realized as I was panicking, you got to get this epidural. They were calling him. I asked like 3 times to call.
Yeah.
And I looked over at my husband and he was kind of like, gave me the face like,
we got to go.
Honey, this is like happening. You're not going to get an epidural.
Nope. It's and I'm happening. Like,
so yeah. You want some blueberries?
Traumatic with physically and even, do you even think a little bit mentally, emotionally, just... Because of the
Oh, completely. I completely underestimated like what pregnancies take out of you.
Yeah.
And I have each time. Okay. But like the first one, I just thought, oh, you know, 6-8 weeks recovery, I'll go back to just working out and being back to normal. I mean, that's what they tell you.
Right.
Your doctor releases you. They give you no understanding of like where, how your body recovers, where all everything goes, you know, and then your hormones have been making and building, yep, a human for 9 months.
Yeah.
I mean, and it lives off you. It has to be. And then it switches into then a different hormonal state to produce milk and take care of this thing. And then it also goes through another one to like when you're all done and tries to go back to normal. And, you know, that can take at least a year for your body to regulate after that. Sometimes can take even longer. My babies were only 22 months and, you know, between. So, yeah, it did take out of me mentally just the routine of like, or even getting back into fitness, like, well, I'm just gonna have another baby again.
Yeah,
that was my mindset. It was just, so I did recover, do pretty well, but I was never like, oh, let's get ripped again, let's like get my body back. Because mentally now I was a mom, I was trying to train, I got back to work.
Yep.
Which learning again, like the fresh word of like pumping when you're in the bathroom, you know, to like at work and, yeah, coming home and to a baby. And, you know, I think going from one or zero to like one was a big transition in our house, you know, and to try to be a wife, yeah, and a mother then and a trainer. I didn't leave the personal training like working world until right after Declan.
Which is?
He's my second child. Oh, second, so my child. Second, okay, one. Yeah. Yeah. So that was a really hard pregnancy.
As in?
I had kidney stones.
Oh.
I gained a lot more weight with him.
Okay.
I had more digestive issues for the first time. Like my Crohn's had gotten better from being healthy and eating well. And then this is the first time during the pregnancy and everything where things just didn't feel like the first time. I could maybe go out and do a couple miles walk, maybe a mile walk or so. It came down to just at least I got the mile, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah. And, you know, his delivery was epidural, but like a really good one, just kind of calm throughout the day, you know, and it was enjoyable. But when I came home from him, I suffered really bad postpartum depression. Our basement flooded like 2 days after we got him home. And so it was like, had this brand new baby. I had a whole room set up that I thought was going to be calm, you know, separated. And then our basement flooded and we had to take everything from our basement and put it all into like the area that I was supposed to like breastfeed my second kid that like I just have a 22 month old at home, you know, like,
yeah, he was still stressful.
Like a toddler. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's fine. Like I said, I look back on it. Yeah, those were the first signs. I just thought I would get back to normal once hormones changed and everything, which I feel like I did. I've had to work pretty hard to be mentally happy.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, over the years. I think all of us do. But
well, especially for you, if you're a wife, mother, you know, coach, all of that's, yeah, got to be there.
I'm giving things out of my cup, yeah, that, and my cup has holes now.
Okay.
You know, so, yeah, that's kind of how I felt, like my energy, my person, my cup as a person of like what you can take and fill up others and make them. I was constantly, because that's where I got my joy. That's where I thought me as helping people is like my spark and teaching and kind of like what God wants me to do.
Yeah.
If I could look back on like where things started to crumble when I say mentally, I think it would actually come down to like spiritually. In college, it was easier to just turn away and not go to church every day. Like,
yeah,
you know,
I'm a college kid. I have to do what my parents say and I don't have to.
Yeah. My father passed away from Lou Gehrig's disease when I was 18 and I went off to college 2 weeks later.
Oh, wow.
So like, I think it was just easy for me to just kind of take that like, fuck life attitude, like, you know, and just like, I'm going to college, like, you know, like, yeah, do whatever I want. Like, and I was in pain and I didn't even want it. Like, I completely compartmentalized and kind of was turned that part of my life off. Yeah. And then I would say when I was in Utah was the first time I started realizing where like I have a severe anxiety of losing people, you know, like, so I'd get like my husband would leave and I would just be like, kind of, yeah,
coming back.
Yeah. And so I started dealing with some of it then. And then I felt like I got to implement a lot of those things again post number two baby, you know? And then he had digestive issues, you know, going into it too, where like he couldn't go to the bathroom, colicky, like okay. you throw those in yeah. for a couple months until we could figure out what was really wrong with him, which is still an ongoing mother journey with that. And, you know, but I think when we really got Noah, when that was where I could decide to train at home and kind of just move and shift everything to small. And then when I had Noah, I actually found CrossFit after Declan. So this okay. is baby number two. I found CrossFit.
So yeah. how did you get into that journey then?
My husband, who had never stuck to like a program or like anything that's structured. He was in college athlete. Like he played college baseball. Very
for
athletic.
His size, really?
He's a catcher.
That's a big catcher.
Yeah. Do you want to know what it's like for people to steal home? He knocks them out. Like, oh yeah, it's oh, awesome. God, and he is beautiful. Like he is so agile for his size.
Yeah.
So he can do things that are just frustrating when you look at big men. You're like, wow, he did that in the first time you've ever attempted it. Like, so he had an opportunity to go to CCMAF.
Okay. Yep.
They have like a Groupon. He joined and he stuck with it. Like we had a 3-month-old Declan at home.
Yep.
Not sleeping. And he'd get his ass up at 5 a.m. and go with that crew every day. I think it got him through it. And so finally he's like, Jackie, I know you're a personal trainer. I know how you feel about CrossFit. And I'm like, babe, it's not that I don't know how I feel about CrossFit. I have a baby, you know, like I have, this is so like, I am now pregnant. Again, we had number two and I just came off of having baby number two where I gained a lot of weight for that pregnancy.
Yep.
Now I'm in postpartum depression. Honestly, I feel like I'm back to the person I was before I ever had kids. Back to like you know, when I had to quit my job at the YMCA.
Yep.
Back to that person.
And then that's when you went to CrossFit.
And that's when I found CrossFit.
Okay.
How's you know that? What I mean?
Yeah.
Honestly, the routine, the science behind it,
yeah.
the community, it was everything I needed. Everything I needed to pull me out of what that was.
Yeah.
Got my body back. I started looking better. I had more confidence. I actually found out I was really good at certain things. I can do box jumps really high. I can do a snatch really well. And it was one of those few moments that just came very naturally to me. And it gave me the confidence back. You know, it made me feel, and it made me train. It switched everything. It started changing my attitude. Every rep counted. Because I wanted it to be perfect.
Yeah.
I started applying that to my house. How many times can I like get up and pick up my kids and move, you know, like, and just the mentality of if I can suffer for 15 minutes and come out feeling great on it, I can suffer through some other things that right. were hard, you yeah. know? So yeah. And endorphins. I mean, like I can go on a list of why CrossFit can just, well, even just that type of functional movement training.
Yeah.
can take anybody and change them. You
yeah,
know?
I mean, that's the I mean, biggest it, thing. Like,
I feel like there's a part where it was before CrossFit and after. That's definitely a strong chapter in my life, you know?
We'll definitely have you back for that. I really think that'd be good because just the connection between people don't realize like, okay, yes, it's CrossFit. I think there's a point where it's like, I think you should at least try it once because yeah. of that mentality can change.
Yes. Completely. And you know what's crazy? We were talking to Matt the other day.
Yeah.
You're where you first met him at CCMAF.
I saw your comment.
That's the one I flip and programmed.
And I
which like,
I think I remember. Did you have colored hair?
I did.
How pregnant were you?
I know. I was pregnant.
Were yeah. you 6 months, seven?
I think it was seven. It was just enough where I finally, like, I was practicing some of that stuff like two, 3 weeks before.
Because you had a microphone. I remember you having a microphone. I was like, gosh, this lady's pregnant and she's announcing right now. Good for her.
Yeah, I loved
like,
it.
Shit.
Like I said, that pregnancy was fun because I got to train.
That was number three, right?
Yeah. Apparently, when you get in really good shape and you're eating really well, you can be really fertile.
Oh,
so he was one of those moments that was we wanted three kids
just not that soon.
Yeah, I was aware because like I said those other two were really close together that I wanted to be fit. I wanted this pregnancy to be completely different, which it was
good,
but I don't feel like I had enough time between it. Like I just hit my lowest like body fat, hit my lowest like my macros were on point, everything was on point,
and then a baby.
So those are the, like, and I would say he's my most beautiful, I wouldn't say that he's my most beautiful one because each one of them has taught me things in my life and has made me so much better.
Yeah.
But he completed it. He iced the family over. He filled all of those voids and showed a lot of other weaknesses, you know, that we had to take care of. So going from two to three was awesome.
Yeah.
And like having the fitness world behind it, like I came out of that pregnancy with so much more muscle mass, like just because I lifted and I lifted with a